In daily life, when a phone faces unexpected issues, no signal repairs often become common and troublesome. Today, we'll demonstrate how to troubleshoot and fix no signal issues on an iPhone 15 Pro. The phone is stuck searching for signal, and the modem firmware is blank. Power off the device, remove the SIM card tray, and then take out the motherboard. Signal issues often stem from motherboard problems. We first verify if soldering issues on the middle layers are to blame, the phone's been repaired before, and the thermal padding's gone. We'll go straight to motherboard separation. Grab the pry knife. Set the heat gun to 320 degrees Celsius at an airflow of 70. And set the desoldering platform to 190 degrees Celsius. Begin prying open the motherboard. Take out motherboard test fixture. It can let us test the motherboard without soldering it back. Before proceeding, we need to clean both the logic board and the signal board. Apply solder flux. Then clean the middle layer with a 380 degrees Celsius solder iron and solder wick. Install the cleaned motherboard onto the test fixture and connect the screen for testing. Boot up the phone with tweezers. Yet the modem firmware still remains blank. Looks like the fault's on the signal board. Let's locate the baseband circuits with a bitmap. Start with these capacitors. Test them with a multimeter. All capacitors' readings are normal. So the problem now narrows down to the baseband CPU. No obvious damage, but a pseudo-soldering might be the issue. Switch to the curved blade and apply captain tape on the board for protection. Use a hot air gun at 320 degrees Celsius to remove the edge adhesive around the baseband CPU, taking care not to damage nearby small components. Then, set it at 380 degrees Celsius. Carefully remove the baseband CPU with the assistance of the pry knife. Finally, the culprit is revealed, the baseband CPU suffers from pseudo-soldering. Let's begin repairing the baseband CPU. First, use a scraper to apply medium temperature solder and solder flux. Then, use a soldering iron at 380 degrees Celsius to blend the original high temperature solder under the CPU, lowering its melting point to prevent damage to nearby components during reballing. Next, continue cleaning the solder joints, using solder wick with the 380 degrees Celsius soldering iron. Align the stencil and evenly apply solder paste with a scraper. Reball the baseband CPU with medium temperature solder. Then heat with a hot air gun at 320 degrees Celsius with an airflow 70 until the solder balls form. Once the CPU solder balls have formed, we perform the same procedure on the solder pads. This helps achieve a faster and more efficient soldering of the CPU. Remember to clean the solder pads with PCB cleaner and use a scraper to remove residual adhesive to level the pads. Next, prepare for re-soldering the baseband CPU. Apply the paste flux. Align the baseband CPU. Set the heat gun to 350 degrees Celsius with an airflow of 60 and solder the baseband CPU. After repair, place the motherboard back into the test fixture for verification. Boot the phone. Modem firmware is restored. Once the solder balls are formed on the signal board, replace the logic board, adjust it with tweezers, and complete the recombination. Finally, reassemble the motherboard into the phone and insert the SIM card. The signal is restored, and the modem firmware is back to normal. Although no signal repairs are common, the process remains challenging. Follow these troubleshooting steps carefully to pinpoint and resolve the issue. REWA Online Shop offers a wide range of repair tools and phone parts. Feel free to contact us for more information.